Good morning, THS. It's Wednesday, January 11th. I'm Zane.
And I'm Sarah, and you're watching Viking News.
Congratulations to the Viking wrestling team for winning the Best of Bristol trophy for the fifth year in a row. The Vikings won 63-9 over the Bearcats, 54-21 over Battle, and 69-6 over the East Patriots. 9 out of 14 weight classes were won by the Vikings.
If you plan to attend the race camp on January 16th, you need to turn in your form to sign up by January 11th if you are planning to ride the bus to school that day.
If you would like to be a student volunteer for the race camp, please fill out a form and return it to the main office. All forms are due by Friday.
The Student Council is having a winter semi-formal dance open to all THS students on Saturday, January 28th from 8 p.m. to 11 p.m. in Viking Hall. Tickets may be purchased during your lunch or after school in room 1219 from January 3rd until the 18th. Please see a Student Council member or one of the sponsors regarding any questions you may have.
Now we have a news story about Winter Guard from Maddie Hurt.
The THS 2016-2017 Winter Guard has always been an award-winning team, but this year the expectations are higher. Winter Guard Captain Taylor Duncan says this team works like a family.
We have a lot stronger bond between members this year. I think we're much more of a family than we have been in the past, and we've done a lot better overall at competitions than we used to. Judging off of how well we did in Fall Guard, I think if we just continue on the same track that we have been, we're going to do better than we ever have in Winter Guard this year. We have a lot of new people coming in, much more guys than we've ever had in the past, and I really think that they're going to rise to the occasion and do very well.
Taylor says she loves doing Winter Guard because of all the great memories she has made with her friends.
My favorite guard memory would definitely be the when for the Only Love Can Hurt Like This show, and we performed at Halls High School, and the lights went out halfway through our performance, and we kept going. Like, the music stopped, the lights were off, and the crowd like got out their phone flashlights and like lit up the floor, and we got to, like, we kept performing and we just counted together, and there's a video of it, and it was just the most, like, that is why I do Winter Guard, is for moments like that, and it was just the best.
So if you want to get involved in a school activity with a family-filled competition and lots of fun and memories, you might want to consider trying out for Winter Guard next year. Reporting for Viking News, I'm Maddie Hurt.
The THS robotics season has started. Anyone interested may still join. Students that participate will be able to attend the trip to competition in Knoxville March 23rd through the 25th. FRIST Robotics is a great way to obtain a scholarship. 4 students will be offered money this year.
The Gym After School program is up and running from 2:30 to 5:30 Monday through Thursday. Check out the school website for the activities that are offered each day.
Now here's Hannah and Haley with your weather forecast and Cafe Watch.
The THS track and field team will have an organizational meeting on Thursday, January 12th, immediately after school in the auditorium. This meeting should last about 30 minutes. This meeting is for anyone interested in running track and field and not playing a winter sport. If you are playing a winter sport, please let Coach Irvin know that you still plan on running track.
In sports news, the Vikings and Lady Vikings will play at Sullivan Central today, starting with JV girls at 3:30. The Viking wrestlers will take on Volunteer and Cock County at Volunteer tonight at 6. The Aqua Vikes have a meet today at THS starting at 6. Good luck to all our Vikings.
In local news, a Bristol man is facing charges after a pedestrian was killed Monday morning in a car crash. The Tennessee Highway Patrol says the crash happened at around 11:30 a.m. on Highway 321. 50-year-old Jeffrey Rouse was killed as he was walking on the side of the road. According to the THP, the car drifted off the road, hitting and killing him instantly.
In national news, a Texas man died from his injuries Monday, Wednesday after being handcuffed in the back of a police car and managing to pull out a gun from his waistband to shoot himself. Zachary Annam, 19, was handcuffed and placed in the back of the seat of a patrol car for a ride to the police headquarters. During the ride, Annam managed to reach for his weapon on the right side of his pants. He pointed the weapon at his head with threats to shoot himself. He later died at a hospital. He had been detained for suspicion of having an illegal substance.
That's all for Viking News.
Have a wonderful Wednesday.
So fast, these are some good times. So take a good look.